What's going on, guys? Blover Bros here. Now, I'm going to do the starting lineup earlier than I normally do because it's a small track. And I want to go over a couple things. First of all, this ain't going to take long. At 7 o'clock tonight, Central, no, Eastern time, so 6 o'clock Central, 4 o'clock Pacific, will be the Traxxas Truck Series race. So, doubleheader. And also, I know what you're going to think by looking at the front row. I put this on my life. I did not rig this. It's just pure coincidence. So, yeah, Adam Akers on, and Kyle Akers on the front row. First time the Akers boys have ever gotten front row like that. You got Larry Arnold and Hunter Spartan. Good to see Hunter qualifying up front. You got Ruby Claudel and Keon Eddington, last season's champ. TJ Friend and Eli Stapleton. Red Bull trying to go back to back here at North Wilkesboro. Try to sweep the weekend. Ooh, God, I'm lost. You got Nick Ventura. He won the last short track race we were at. And TJ Hanley. You got Alvin Summers and Mo Akers. Eli Bright and Jay Jefferson. Eli was not happy about what happened in the amateur series race. He got wrecked going for the lead pretty much by lapped cars. So can he redeem himself today? And Jay Jefferson, you got Brad Stover, who won last week at Atlanta, and Muhammad Zane. Joseph Rakowski, who had a tough day yesterday, to say the least, and Ryan Kesey. Then you got Colin Francis, and yesterday's winner, the first ever win for Red Bull on Blover Bros, you got Max Anderson. Bullet Bill and Dalton Riley. Jeff Bright and Rebecca Tyler, Kevin Villano and Alexander Rowe, Luciana Reese and Nathan Stapleton, Kyle Kesey and Nick Flood, Sumit Ozgen and Brayson Mitchell, Isaiah Forward and Jonathan Hoff, Burt Forward and Evan, are they forwards? Okay, and Evan Burton. I have the attention span of a squirrel, so I apologize. Kapula Bai and Ryan Madden. Ryan just had an awful season. Dylan E and Amy Ashley. Yeah, Tyler Flood and Logan Claudel. Well, here we go for the command.
Drivers, start your engines!
I almost did the intro again. All right, here we go. We got the command. Wait for it to roll off any minute now. Adam Akers, I think, third pole of his career. Five seasons, well, four, like an eighth. And zero oval wins to his credit. But he is a past champion in both the Vodafone F1 Series, which, big news, is making a return in a big way. All cars on equal. It's going to be great. He was champion of that last season and the Monster Energy IROC Series champion. And Kyle Akers, alongside next to him, has one College Cup Series win to his credit. It was the season finale of Season 1 at Homestead. So here they go for 80 laps. Hopefully this isn't a wreck fest like yesterday. Can Red Bull sweep North Wilkesboro? Remember, Traxxas Truck Series is tonight at 7. That doesn't matter. This is called a Cup Series. Here we go, coming to the green. The Akers boys lead him to the green in North Wilkesboro. First time we've raced here since Season 3. Hendrick Motorsports won that race last time. Cody Brennan in the 48 cars. 48's last win. A couple videos I mistakenly said 48's last win was Season 2. It was actually Season 3 in North Wilkesboro. Cody Brennan, haven't said that name in forever. But Hunter Spartan, man, the outside lane is just non-existent. There's no rubber laid down up there. It's just not good. They're three wide mid-pack. So Adam does lead lap number one. We've actually completed a lap, which is impressive. This is the Cup Series, though, so these guys, a lot more experience. And, oh, no, I lied. Boy, did I lie. Caution is out. Adam will lead them back. Oh, I gotta love it. All right, we'll go check out what just happened. Nathan Stapleton, the rookie for Stuart Haas. Let's see what happened. Sumit Ozgen tried making it three wide, and oh god, I pushed the wrong button. Yeah, Sumit tried making it three wide, and just far too aggressive early on. I don't think he was doing anything, trying to make anything happen like that. Just 14 slid up, and then kind of cut back down. It could have worked for the 14, I guess, didn't know. I'm not sure if Bird actually hits the wall right here. I'm still not sure because they have a damn, I don't even know what that's for, the little stand there. So I'm pretty sure Nathan was smoking. Okay, so Bert did hit the wall. I think he will be alright. Was Nathan good? I think they're gonna be alright, so we'll be back for the restart. And look at this race off pit road, 3x3. Not everyone pit. I think the 11 actually ran to the back at the 22. Yeah, he did. He's got a little hood damage. Man, Bryson's had a tough weekend, hasn't he? All right, we're back for the restart. Pace car is off. Oh, Sumit actually retired. I'm not sure what happened. We'll have to go check that out next caution. Hopefully I remember. Coming to the grid on lap 8. TJ Friend, I think only took 2 tires. Then jumped up to 2nd. So, that is very interesting. I think he was like 7th or 8th at the time of the caution. And Adam slides high. Way to bash Pro Shops car on the wall. Adam slid high, but the 83 with older, not, I mean, I guess they only ran like 3 laps. So I don't think it makes a difference, honestly. But he just can't quite get the run. Red Bull has shown speed this weekend. The longest green flag run yesterday was 9 laps, and it was the final 9 laps. So can we beat that today? Because if not, it's going to be a long race. Oh, and the 83 is pulling off along with the 4. I thought I heard scraping. Did they just wreck? They did. Wow, all right. Nick Ventura is the big move right now. He's worked his way up to 3rd. Let's go see what happened. This could be a long race. This honestly took forever for him to find. Looks like rookie Alvin Summers had a little trouble. I'm not sure exactly what happened. All right, Ryan Key's got a huge run off the outside, and I don't think. Oh, Rebecca Tyler, man, she. Ooh, Jay Jefferson. Oh, Max Anderson. Dalton Riley. Oh man, Kapula buys in it. Kevin Villano. Rebecca Tyler, man, if she didn't have bad luck, she wouldn't have any luck at all. She should have won Atlanta. She had the quickest car without a doubt, and she lost a tire with 3 to go. Dang it, I hate that for her. She was running 17th, so not having the best run, but no one's going to expect that to happen right in front of you. Really nothing she could do. Oh, and if that's not her Call of Duty Cup Series career in a nutshell, let's watch the 43 of Luciana Reese. See, Rebecca's down low, and the 43 gets hit, and right into the 42. Tough break, tough break. Now, how did Kyle Kesey in the 16 get involved? Oh, well, he's gone. This is rough. Man, he picked up a lot of spots right here. Everyone's going high, and boom, right into the back of the 43, then up into the 11. Oh, and then Tyler Flood got in our vector the restart. The pace car has pulled off. We are coming to the green on lap 15. Now, those retirees from that crash was Kyle Kesey, Brayson Mitchell, Ryan Madden, Nathan Stapleton, and Alvin Summers. A couple people multiple laps down. How many on the lead lap? 31. Kapula Bai somehow on the lead lap. Adam with an amazing restart. Oh, the lap car's going 3 wide. This did not work yesterday, guys. Don't do this. Oh, there they go. Oh my god! Oh my Jesus. Yeah, caution is no doubt out. Mo Akers, man. Now, we'll be right back. Yeah, a lot of guys checking up here. They're not happy with one another and they're wrecking under caution. So that's lovely. And we've actually just happened. We're going helicopter view. Mo Akers running just outside, actually in the top 5 right here. He's that little blue car. See, he got into the 31 and then down into the 02. And, oh my god, Jeff Bright was in it. He's running really high up in points. Amy Ashley even got a piece of it. That is the definition of unfortunate. But, judging by the wreck we saw, looks like he did that to himself. Jeff Bright inside the top 15 on board. I'm not going to do any fancy editing because on a time crunch. That's why there hasn't been any races lately. So, oh my god. I want to go on board Jay Jefferson there. Oh my god, headbutt of my mic. Oh, hot good driving. Good on you, Jay Jefferson. All right, we've picked the restart. Bad news for the guy who's led every lap thus far. Adam Akers pit under that caution. Let's check out the DNFs from that last wreck. You got Jeff Bright, Mo Akers, Amy Ashley, Evan Byrne, Bullet Bill, and Kevin Villano. Jesus. All right, Adam pit under caution from while leading, and he's down in 9th. So playing a little strategy. His brother Kyle stays out. Nick Ventura spinning his tires mad hard. Oh no, left guard's making it 3 wide. This did not work yesterday. I don't think it's gonna work right here. Just don't collect any lap or the lead lap cars. Oh guys, stop. Give me a heart attack. It's so stressful. I don't like having caution like wreck fest. Oh man, Jay Jefferson almost just dumped Eli Bright. Eli had a really tough race yesterday. He was frustrated as all. Ooh. Alright. That was interesting. Oh, I think I seen a wreck in the back. Oh no. But a couple of rookies giving each other like slight bump and runs. Trying to check out where the Adam Akers worked his way. Adam Akers worked his way up to fifth, and he's rubbing on the 91. Brad Stover. A lot of fuel strategy going on right now. This can give me a heart attack, guys. I don't play favorites, but I don't like seeing lapped cars race the leaders like they're contending. It just gives me a panic attack. Who is the leader? Okay, Kyle Akers, Nick Ventura, Alexander Rowe, your 500 winner, Adam Akers, and Eli Stapleton, I think. No, I think he picked. Who's, is it Keon? It is. Okay. Oh, man, we seen this happen yesterday. A lap car came out of the pits and nailed someone trying to get down into the pit. So hopefully you guys don't pit. There they go. I'm getting too old for this, guys. I'm almost 20. My heart can't take it. Getting too old. Too stressful. Oh, man. I think we've already passed 9 laps on this run. Don't do this, guys. You have families. Adam Akers, easily having the best race. Actually, he dominated Texas in the chase last season. He didn't get the win, but he did dominate. Brayson Mitchell actually stole that win. Brayson and Adam are longtime rivals. So, Adam got second, his career best finish. But I think this might be his best chance of getting a victory. I don't know, he had a good car. And now he's faster than the 2, but the 83 is on the inside, and he really can't get by him. They have a lot of lap cars in front of him. This is why you like short track racing, because now Keon's going to try attacking his teammate, Adam. Sure, remember who's all on Hendricks this season. I was thinking, is Keon the only Hendrick driver with a win in the Call of Duty Cup Series? Adam is now pushing Alexander Rowe. But Jeff Bright in the 24 actually won 2 races last season. Both with the 24 car. So right now we have a 4-car battle for 3rd. This is great racing. I know we're not watching the battle for the lead, but this is better in my opinion. 4 cars, the 25, the 2, and the 1. Almost going 3 wide for 4th. Luckily Dylan E, the rookie, and the number 1 backed off. Because that probably would result in all 3 cars getting turned. And you can tell why Keon's a champion. He got in there, stole the positions, and drove off. Nice grammar. Now on to lap 31, the 5, trying to get by Rebecca Tyler. What place is she in? Holy shit, she's like PG. She's 11th. Dang, she went up in the air earlier. I don't play favorites, but I really like Rebecca Tyler, man. She is a racer. She should have won Atlanta last week. She has no hood. The back end looks like it got hit by a semi. And she's running 11th. That is insane. I think she's the first car lap down as well because of pit stops. So I'm sure she's not actually 11th once everything cycles back. But, God. You gotta like that, man. Kyle Akers pulling away. Oh, God. Is there a caution? Because the O2 is damaged. No, okay. Kyle Akers pulling away. Nick Ventura. Is every RCR car rookie this season? Yeah, Nick Ventura, Nick Flood, no, Isaiah Ford. Who might as well be a rookie. Man, 4 seasons, 0 wins. And 0 this season, so 5th season. Eli Bright, though, won in his first ever Call of Duty Cup Series start last season's Daytona 500 champion. And looks like they're, I don't like when lap cars do this. I get passing if you're faster, but don't go 3 wide. Luckily, Ryan Madden, experienced driver, never won, but made it the final 4 last season. Got second in points. Luckily, he was experienced enough not to take him 3 wide. Looks like Adam actually has caught Keon Eddington back there. Kyle Akers is pulling away. Kyle Akers' last win on Blover Bros was the season one finale of IROC. It was at Talladega, and he won that race. Where his little brother Adam clinched, the, or not clinched, but won the championship. He only clinched the championship at the end of the last race, I guess. We're nearing halfway. Are they coming out of turn four? Okay, four and a half laps. Oh, no, no, no. Three and a half laps. Coming up to three to halfway right now. Ryan Madden faster than the leader. I'm going to be pissed if they wreck the leader. That happened yesterday. Oh, he's pushing him. These two, Kyle Akers and Ryan Madden, both made the final four last season. Yeah, if I'm Kyle, I'm letting these guys go. It's so early. You clearly have one of, if not the best car here. He stayed out on that last caution when a couple people pitted. Or pitted. I don't know if pitted actually worked, but pit. And he's pulled away three and a quarter seconds. And he's pitting now. Who's second? Does Keon and Adam follow? I didn't think so because they pit during that last caution. So this is the battle for the lead between Hendrick Motorsports. And cautioned out. Happened last time. The leader pit as soon as caution comes out. So that really just screwed Kyle Akers. I don't know. He's still on the lap. Let's go see what happened. Can you believe it? One of the most unluckiest drivers in all of the Call of Duty Cup Series history, Blover Bros history, Isaiah Ford, gets caught up in yet another wreck. I'm pretty sure teammates just wrecked each other, and Isaiah got PG. Can't say it. I am fairly certain the 28 of Eli Bright dumped his teammate. The 38 and 28 are both from Robbie H Racing, and both cars are absolutely destroyed. Yeah, he's pushing through the turns. I would love to be a fly on the wall on Monday in the Robert H. Racing boardroom, or whatever they're called. Some fancy word. Oh, Muhammad was fifth and he got dumped by his teammate. Ridiculous, man. Ridiculous. I'm going back for the restart. Yeah, look at him. He's pissed. Go and get him. Go get him, Muhammad. We're going to keep care of him. Go get him. Is he... What you doing there, 38? Alright, we'll go with the restart. What? He was fifth when he wrecked, but now he's up to fourth. I forgot. You gotta love that race back roll. Alright, we'll be back for the restart.
Pace car pulls off.
No one DNF from that wreck. Muhammad Zain. Oh my god. Talk about luck, man. Last year's Veterans Day Memorial winner. The first ever. So, one of the biggest races we've ever had. Muhammad Zain. Yeah, wrecked by his teammate. Was that a little spin gate? I think Adam might be fitting right here, the way the two jumped to the outside. Yep. That almost caused a wreck. I don't know why you didn't just pin it to caution. Oh, I don't like this. Muhammad didn't pit, and he spun. So those, they're four wide back there. Muhammad didn't pit. He spun. He's up to third because Adam pit. But those tires got to be trashed. He had a flat spot the living crap out of him. Oh, Nick Ventura might just dump Rebecca Tyler right here. Larry Arnold, last season's Amateur Series champion. I don't think Larry gets as much respect in this series as he deserves. Let's be serious between you and me right here. Excuse me. Just choking on spit. Larry Arnold. I'm being serious. Larry Arnold won the Season 2 FedEx Amateur Series champion. He won the championship last season. No easy feat. It's even more impressive. Guess how many laps he led? Zero. He did not lead one lap at all. This guy is the definition. I should probably put the camera. Okay. Chill, Muhammad. Chill. Larry Arnold led zero laps en route to his Amateur Series championship. Here he's running second. He hasn't led a lap yet. He don't care. You don't need him with lead laps to win championships. You gotta be consistent. But we should probably go focus on the leader. Wait, is he? There's five cars on the lead lap. Oh, Adam Pitt, when we went green. I thought he pitted a caution. I'm like, how is the five not on the lead? How is it only five cars on the lead lap? These cautions are screwing these guys due to when they're pitting. Yeah, Adam's down at 25th. You know he's pissed. He laps down. Oh, Keon actually DNF'd due to an accident. How is that not a caution? It was fresh, too. Yeah, Adam's down two laps. I think that's his race is done. Unless green flag pit stops happen right here. He needs this race to go green. And then he needs a caution as soon as he gets back on lead lap. Alexander Rowe, your Daytona 500 winner. Yet another driver who won in his first career start. Nick Ventura needs the two to get up there and battle. Or just stay up there and battle the nine. Because Nick needs to get back on lead lap. RCR has, if you want to be technical, won every RCR has won every RCR race. RCR has won every short track race this season in the Cup Series. They won Phoenix. Nick Ventura got it. I mean they won Rockingham, not Phoenix. Phoenix is this weekend. They won Rockingham. Nick Ventura got it. They also won that's the only short track this season, but they're undefeated. And Kyle Aker's trying to get Everham their first win since Auto Club last season when Tyler Flood sealed the deal. Speaking of Tyler Flood, where is he running? You put, 27th of that hood. Back to Kyle Aker's. Dalton Riley, something's wrong with that car. The rookie out of Joe Gibbs Racing. Kyle Aker's starting to run high. I don't know if the 2 is going to pit or if the 9 has really old tires. Looks like the battle for second is getting lit. I'm Burt Ford wrecking that first caution, chilling in 17th. TJ Hanley, yet another guy who keeps pitting. Twat is going on. Who's in second? Okay, Larry Arnold. I thought there was a battle, but apparently not. I'm surprised Muhammad Zayn has kept that car in contention, really, for second. He's just... Look at the damn thing. That car is as wrinkled as an empty bag of M&Ms. Awful joke, I know, but it's the truth. I mean, the passenger side looks pretty good. Where's Max Sander? How's he doing? 21st, man. He won yesterday, got Red Bull their first ever win. Isaiah Ford's probably mad as all hell right now. He got wrecked whenever the teammates wrecked each other. He fell down 22nd off of it. Muhammad Zayn's third. And in front of him, on track, so. Eli Bright and Jay Jefferson are running pretty well. Adam Aker's still 25th. He's passed a lot of cars, actually, though. I feel like he's behind a yellow car or something. No, he's behind, wasn't he behind the 43? I don't know. Luciana Reese, man, she got turned into Rebecca Tyler. She's running 12th, atta girl. Go on and get him. Joseph Rakowski in the 5th. It's so weird how far the lap cars are all between them, and it's confusing me. But good on you, Joseph. Made a couple guys mad yesterday, but you know, you live. That's how you learn as a rookie. Oh, Adam. I get you're frustrated, bro. If you need chill, you just dump two rookies. I mean, if you need a caution, you need a caution. I don't know if Kyle Akers, his own brother, is happy with that. He had almost 3 seconds on the field. All right, let's go check what happened. We're gonna go onboard Adam because while rewinding, I noticed something. I never watched the wreck. I watched it live with y'all for the first time, but when I'm rewinding, I do catch a glimpse of it. But while rewinding, it looked like he tried avoiding the O2, but he had such a big run with new tires that they almost stacked him in front of him. Look, he tried going high right here, and I don't know. Yeah, I don't think he intentionally did that because that hurt his own car. But I don't know. You guys know as well as I do. Do you guys know? Because I don't. As long as he's been here, I can't imagine him intentionally dumping someone. Is TV2 not going to change? Okay, there we go. That was an awful camera view. Thanks, game. Well, at least Dalton Riley has a reason to keep hitting now. That might have been karma for Eli Stapleton dumping his teammate. Actually, is that Eli? It is, okay. There's so many Stapletons, man. You should never know anymore. I don't know. All right, we'll be back for the restart.
The pace car pulls off.
Who retired? Alexander Rowe retired. I'm not sure why he was in front of the leader, but Adam, now 24th. He's going to be livid at the end of this race. Five cars on the lead lap. Kyle Akers cleared Brad Stover with relative ease. I think that just... I don't know. Larry Arnold got by Brad as well. No. I don't know. I think Brad's letting Larry by because... Yeah. Most of the drivers did pit under that caution. So, right now your top five goes Kyle Akers, Larry Arnold, Muhammad Zane, Logan Caudill, and Joseph Rakowski. How about that? The rookie. If I'm not mistaken, that is... Yeah, he's your only rookie in the top five. Oh man, Larry is catching. See, did he gain any? He actually stayed exactly the same. Which, no change is a good thing, I guess, considering the rest of the field lost time. I don't think they're in catch lap traffic. 11 to go this time by. Larry's trying a different lane, or line. I don't know if he's actually gained. He lost 0.02. Meanwhile, Muhammad lost 0.5. Where is Joseph? Logan Caudill trying to get by his teammate Hunter Spartan. This will not be for position, but it will help the 22. Where is the... I don't know why it's sexy what place he's in. I know what place he's in. Larry lost a little bit more time. He did not have a good season in the Cup Series last season. Like I said, he was consistent in the Amstrad Series enough to win the championship without leading the lap. I don't think you guys understand how important that is. He was not in first place crossing the line at all in any race. So, that's pretty mind-blowing. Oh, and lapped car. Oh, this could be it. I don't know, actually. I think the other six have fresh tires. I don't know if they can catch them. Oh, Nick Ventura running sixth and lost a motor with nine to go for him. That's unfortunate, to say the least. Where's that going to put him? It's going to put him about 26th. Yeah. Well, yeah. See, Larry's losing time now. They're not going to catch lap traffic with 7 to go. He needs the 9 to start screwing up and bad. Oh, Caudill, look how destroyed that car is, and he's 4th. That is incredible. Meanwhile, Hunter Spartan's car looks pretty damn good. A little damage on the back end. And he's 14th a lap down. Probably 2, actually. Oh, no. Okay, I seen the 30. I seen some. Nick Ventura, camshaft problems. That's not exactly ideal this late in the race. Or any point of the race, honestly. Let's see. 1968. 1966. He was faster. And it showed because he gained a little bit, but now we're coming up to 4 to go. He's gonna need to gain a lot more than that. Let's compare lap times this time by. What will Kyle Akers run? In 1972. Oh, in 1973. So 4 thousandths of a second faster than Larry Arnold. And you see, to gain on the leader, you have to have a faster lap time than him, or else you're just not gaining. And you know he lost 4 thousandths of a second that time. What about this time? 3 to go. I feel like that didn't change at all. 1979 and 1981. Yeah. He ain't gaining now. He done burned him up. They're on catch lap traffic. 2 laps to go. Kyle Akers looking to get his second career Quality Cup Series win. A first since season 1. How long ago was that? Almost 3 years ago. So, it's going to be huge for Kyle Akers. A whole lap traffic. I don't think it's going to matter. Coming up to a lap to go, the 06, probably going to peel off to the pits. So, if he does get close enough, I think that could screw him up, but I don't think so. White flag is out. Unless they have a camshaft. Ooh, the 9 goes high. I think it actually helped him pull away. That's incredible. No, yeah, 33 is coming. Coming to the checkered flag, Kyle Akers is a 2-time Quality Cup Series winner. Kyle Akers wins at North Wilkesboro. Larry Arnold, career best, second place. Muhammad Dane, questionable crash there, got third. Logan Caudill fourth, and Joseph Rakowski, top five for the rookie. Let's go look at the official results, so let's accelerate so everyone can finish. All right, your top 10, I already did your top five. So sixth on back is Dylan Eve, Eli Bright, a couple of, the three of the four DEI guards in the top seven. And yeah, Jay Jefferson, TJ Friend, and Ruby Cladell. Luciana Reese, man, 11th, good on her. Adam Akers down in 19th, heartbreaking. Nick Ventura, 26th. Dalton Rally pit probably 18 times, and he is 27th. 18 laps down, so he probably feel like 9 times, but still. A bunch of DNFs. That's it. Congratulations to Kyle Akers. Remember, the Trek Series race from Phoenix is in literally 6 hours. So hopefully you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys so much for watching. Once again, congratulations to Kyle Akers. And as always, we'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.